Hello guys, KP Shamino here with a video about the new release 075 release. So I'm going to show you guys what they implemented in the game, what is going to happen the next couple of days. So first of all, we are going to get double experience weekend, so that's really good for the guys that want to level to level 40. It's now the time to do it. Then we are still getting the disabling the cooldown function until Monday. I said that yesterday in my video, and I hope Monday that they just get rid of it, to be honest, because I never understood why they put it in the game. It's not fun, and yeah, it's just limiting your fishing. So I don't like it, and I know a lot of people don't like it. So maybe Monday they just throw it away and never think about it again. Then we got the Valentine's tournament. So the crappy Valentine Cup, and that's a little bit further in the info. We got the new pech in Florida too with the tarpon. So I went already to Florida. I was fishing there for 1 hour in that pech, and guess what? I didn't get one fish. So yeah, don't ask me why, because that place is totally full with markers on the water. I tried shrimps, I tried bass jigs, I tried crankbaits, I tried shiners, I tried everything. But it seems that the water was active, but the fish was not in the water. So maybe they just need to put the fish still in the water. We will see how it goes the next couple of days. Then we got a DLC that is not 100 euros for once. It's 9.9 euros only. So I'm not sure what is in the DLC. I hope there is some cool stuff in it. I think that the DLC can go maximum to 20 euros. Because to be honest, it's just... like, yeah, equipment that we got in the game that got like a little bit painted with a little bit color, a little bit skin. That's all what we got for that money. So I think this is good. I'm not sure what we get for it. I hope that we get something cool for it. But I'm not a DLC man. I only buy DLCs if they are not expensive. So then the Valentine Cup crappy, or the crappy Valentine Cup. And they did something very good with it. So now... with the series, you just need to play the series in a time frame of 20 hours. It's not going to take 20 hours, no. It's not like in the past that you need to be at that time, on that moment. You need to fish for 2 hours and then you go to the next series or the semifinals. No, you got now a time frame, and that's very good. Because I know a lot of guys need to work. I need to work too. The previous tournament I was totally fucked because I need to work. I came home for the series. Then I need to go back to work. I came home for the semifinals and I fell asleep. That was how it was. I was looking to my screen, but my hand was not moving anymore. So I was, what the fuck is this? But my brain was sleeping and my eyes were open. So I think a lot of people like that, because it's only for the qualifiers. I can understand that, because the semifinal and the final, you always need to have the adrenaline and you always need to have a look what the competition is doing. So I like it, but in the qualifier that's not really needed, because yeah, who is the competition? You just need to be sure that you are, yeah, the best, the top 20, because the top 20 of each 3 qualifiers goes to the semi, so that's 60 people, and then 20 people of those 60 go to the final. So 14th February qualifier 1 in Mudwater River, the 15th in Rocky Lake, the 16th in California, the 18th it's the semifinals in Quanchken Lake, and then the 19th it's in North Carolina. The moment that I read that North Carolina, I thought right away about that explode, how you need to fish the competition there. I'm not sure it's still in the game. I hope it's not in the game anymore. Otherwise, I think that the final is going to be 20 guys that are just jiggling from left to right the whole time. And the guy that got the most RNG is going to win that competition. Okay, it's not only crappy that you get from that kind of fishing. You get pumpkin seed, you get bluegill too. I'm not even sure that you can use it on the crappy, but I hope they fixed it. Because I'm sure that you can use that if that is still in the game in the final. So fingers crossed, guys, that it's not in the game anymore. But the good thing is, it's not for real money. So it's just for in-game money. The prize pool, 200,000 credits. That's not really a lot for prize one. But then 5,000 bitcoins, that's ridiculous. So I think if they give that amount of bitcoins, I think that the cooldown is going to stay into the game, to be honest, because I'm not sure what you can do with 5,000 bitcoins. Otherwise, I think you can buy every bitcoin. Yeah, maybe the crankbait. Yeah, but 5,000 bitcoins is a lot compared to credits. Second place, 100,000 credits, 3,000 bitcoins. Third place, 50,000 and 1,000 bitcoins and unique equipment. And that's the section that I like. So I like unique equipment. Therefore, I'm back hardcore competition playing at the moment just for the X series. Don't ask me why, but I always said it in my videos a million times, I think. People like that stuff. I like that stuff too. I not even think that the X series is better than normal gear. I never saw an advantage because I tried it a lot of times in competition, and guess what? I came back to the normal gear because I got the impression that there is no difference between it, I think. They say it on the forum, it is a little bit better, but it's such a marginal better thing, or how you call it, I don't know, but I don't. Yeah, I use it a lot. It looks cool, and that's what I like. Then you get like a new cap too, so that's really cool with the 3D avatars. Then you can put your cap in somebody's face that he cannot see anything anymore. So a cool cap. The bigger the cap, the better, I always say. So then we got a list of changes, new feature added. We got a lip grip, and that's the lip grip is something that you hook a fish on, and then you can lift it. Because I just saw it in the New York competition. Then they improved the fishing license, and I think 50% of the community is coming back if they read that, because that's one of the big three that get people away. For me, the big three is first, the economy sucks. The second one is the cooldown on the forward time, and the third one is the license. If they fix those three, they got probably 1,000 players more, but yeah, you never know it in this game. I don't think they are going to fix it. It's how it is, and it will always be the same story. But this is okay. I'm not sure what they mean with notifications. I hope it's like a very big pop-up that comes on the screen, because I can understand you got fined. I got fined in Louisiana. That's the only place that I don't have the unlimited license, and I got fined already two times, so I can understand it. And they are change the fishing fines too. So I hope they lower it a little bit, because we change, you never know. They can put it higher too. Maybe 15,000 currency if you take a crappie and you don't have, like, let's say you don't have the license. That's always a possibility too. So then the next one, I don't know what they mean with it. And then the next one, I thought about it and I don't have a clue what they mean with it. Now you can buy unlimited license with negative credit balance. Okay, so the unlimited license you buy with bitcoins. That are not credits. Credits are the real money. So what is the advantage about that? So if I got minus 5,000 currency and I got 500 bitcoins, I can buy the unlimited license. Okay, that's cool. But I only can travel to Texas. Because travel fee is with credits and not with bitcoins. So I don't have a clue what they mean with it. Maybe somebody can help me, but I'm not smart enough to understand this, to be honest. Fixed wrong message, that is just some bugs, the other ones. So what do I remember about the update? We got a tournament, a crappy tournament. I'm just a little bit afraid of North Carolina. I'm happy that we can get some new telescopic. I'm happy that the cooldown bug is still gone, but I already said it yesterday. I'm happy that they fixed the license problem. I hope they fixed the license problem. And I'm happy that we got double experience. So by the end of the weekend, everybody can be level 40. And then you guys don't need to be worried about getting broke, because then the fun part starts. You can make money in this game. You can get a big fish, and the fun part starts again. So that was it for the guide, guys. If I got the tarpon, I'm going to make a guide how you need to catch them. But like I said, I was there for 1 hour, and it was not my best hour in Fishing Planet. But maybe tomorrow is a better day if the barometric is okay and my RNG is okay. And I got the right temperature and I got my right socks on too and my right hat. Maybe I can catch some fish tomorrow. But thanks for watching, guys. See you later. Have fun with Fishing Planet. Bye bye.